It's so good to have this tour come. We've seen and heard so much about it around the world. How's it been for you as you approach number 100?
This tour began February in Connecticut. We had done a beautiful week of pre-production. We're working out the kinks on the stage indoors. It was in a casino. So during the weekdays, the casino is rather quiet. You know, you go up to the hotel room, come down to the arena, everything's peachy. We start to hear weather reports about a pending snowstorm, not really paying attention, going up and down. Show day, two governors close every major thoroughfare, and day one is about to be postponed. A blizzard hits. Those who are already stuck in the hotel are going to be there for a while, and the word from on high comes that we've got to pack the trucks up in order to make it out of there in time to get down to Washington, D.C. So the first show became a matinee. We packed up the trucks and got out of there. I should have taken all of that as a sign, but no, I took it as a challenge, and we did the show. We made show number two. Here I am at show number 98, and it has been a crazy roller coaster ride, you know, not with a lot of great things, but a couple of incredibly bad things. And yet we persevered, and, you know, we'll get through.
The response has been incredible. When something like what happened with Richie, how do you go through the next day? How do you keep going?
How do we go through that day? You know, I mean, it was 3:30 in the afternoon when you get a phone call that says, I'm not coming. And it wasn't even from him. So, show goes on. You know, this isn't like in the movies where, you know, you just cut to another scene. There's 100 people on the road. There was a record that was coming in at number one on the Tuesday. There was, you know, fans that have flown around the world to be in different places to see you at different times. There's families that rely on those paychecks. That's a big operation to just say, oh, I don't want to go to work today. That's not how it works. So was it easy? Hell no, you know. But we persevered, and we've been blessed that the people that come to see us at night have understood that. And a real career has its ups and its downs.
Sure.
And if you're lucky enough, they stick with you through them.
Are you and Richie talking?
Yeah, a little bit. There was no fight. And there was not, like he'd said to Richard on the Today Show here, there was no fight. There was no money. He just wanted to stay home. So like we had said, it was personal reasons. It wasn't my business to tell the world what those personal reasons were.
You have the most amazing, huge, big car as part of this Buick, as part of this set. How's that to transport around the world? Easy?
No. It's hard to put in the overhead compartment on the airplane. No. It's a big ordeal. You know, it's massive. And we had both an indoor stage that was completely different than this stadium stage. So, it, like I said, these aren't the things where you just say, okay, we're done. I don't want to go to work today. It's good. You know, this is millions of dollars and hundreds of people and people that depend on you. So it's well worth it in the end, but it's a huge ordeal.
Being an extraordinary rock star, traveling the world, you have experiences that the rest of us can only just sit back and go, wow. Do sometimes even you pinch yourself when you find yourself up on stage and Prince William's in one ear and Taylor Swift in the other? Do you sort of go, wow, how surreal?
Sure, almost every day. Well, it was great. It's humbling, it's great, it's exciting. It's photos that you'll share with your kids. They were fortunate to be there. These are the kind of memories that I've been blessed with. It made for a great evening.
Can he sing?
Absolutely. Truthfully, in tune, loud, knew the words, absolutely in tune.
Looking back on the film clips with the big hair back in the day, was it a sad day when you cut your hair?
No. You know, beauty about when I did that is that it actually made headlines in the news, which was hysterical. But at the time, in truth, I really have been at this long enough that I've grown up in public. And if I had come into this room to meet you today at 51 years old, looking like I did at 21 years old, I wouldn't be too proud of that. But when I was 21 years old, and that's what the look in the world was, those are my baby pictures. So I can laugh at them just as much as anyone else can, you know? And in truth, I'm okay with the fact that I grew up in public and yeah, these are my baby pictures, but I'm really proud that I'm not here like the fat Elvis guy.
You've been on the road with the band together for 30 years. Another 30? Can you see yourself keeping on going? That's a definite no?
I think it's a definite no.
When you're on stage, you are a very happy man. You like being up there and playing. And I would think that that's something that you kind of might want to keep doing years into the future.
I love doing it when I'm doing it. But I'm on the other side of the world upside down right now.